Good morning. It's beautiful out, not gonna lie. Like, I don't even know, minus 3, 4, 5, something like that, but there's zero wind right now. So the plan of attack today is to fish outside all day. Two lines, hopefully. Gonna run one about probably, I don't know, 10 to 14, 15 inch Cisco, something like that, on the bottom. I hope we score a great big mama, plus an active jig all day, which will be a tube jig and a spoon. I'll kind of switch it up a little bit. Run and gun is the key today, hopefully. Move around a lot. If I'm marking fish or I'm catching fish, I'll kind of stay in one little spot for a while. But if I'm not catching, I'm gonna try a couple different spots today. Search some new water too that I've never fished before. Obviously I've fished half the Pap Lake, but there's some areas I wanna check out that I've never dropped a line in that I might today. So let's get some holes drilled here and get to a fishing. Okay, I've got the dead stick over there. I'm gonna start with a confidence bait for me with the chartreuse tube. Yeah, haven't marked any fish yet from what I've seen yet, but hey, that's the way she goes. Now that I'm ready, maybe the fish will come by. I'm fishing single 10 inch holes, which isn't ideal, but I'm not as worried since I don't have the camera cord to worry about right now. Yeah, that's my story. Once the sun comes out, it's gonna be beautiful. If the sun comes out, you guys keep an eye on the dead stick for me. Feels so weird without fishing with the camera. I'm so used to just staring at it all day long. Okay, I got a bunch of marks. I bet you if I go to my spoon, I could catch one of these fish. I do want to catch a bunch of fish today, so let's see if that is the case. Spoon, spoon, spoon. Here we go. Got him, got him. Very, very light hit. That was different. This is a small little guy. He's tiny. Tiny trout. That was a very, very light bite, but I think the reason why is it's a tiny guy. Small. Yep, that's one of the smallest Lakers I've caught here. But hey, that's what you get when you use a small little spoon, right? You're gonna catch some runts too. I'm not used to handling little guys like you. Little guy, but the first trout of the day, fishing outside. I love it. Okay, we're gonna go back to my tube jig a little bit. I'll keep this guy right here in my back pocket here. Got him. I got hit on the downstroke. I was just dropping it a little bit and all of a sudden I felt him pick it up. So I had to reel down to him and then hit him because I was kind of in an awkward spot. It's not very big either, but the bite is starting to pick up as this is fish two of the day. A little bit bigger than the first one I caught though, that's for sure. There's my leader. And there he is. Like I said, he's not big, but he is a little bit bigger than the first one of the day. Yes. Okay, come here, you. Okay, hook comes out nice and easy. No problem. Trout to the day. Again, little guy, but bigger than the first one. They're getting bigger. You know, I'm just packing up to move spots. I thought, you know what? I'll go over my sled real quick because that's probably the cool thing to do, right? I'm such a donkey. So my sled is very basic 600 Polaris RMK, not an ice fishing sled, of course, but it's what I have and it's what I'll continue to use until I get an actual ice fishing sled. I got mounted a Helix 7 Gen 2. I use that for all the waypoints. And then also maybe some mapping I did at a lake to kind of follow the contour lines. It's super handy, a little overkill. Probably Helix 5 up there would be perfect, but that's what I have. And I have a little Plano box that I mounted on the tunnel here with some rod holders there. And you can see I got a variety of tube jigs and some spoons. And then I have a digger auger rack here, which holds the Strike Master Lithium. And then of course I have an Otter sleigh. Sometimes I'll tandem the sleighs depending on what I need to take for the day. Today I didn't bring a heater, didn't bring a shelter. I tried to just keep it really basic, tried to run in gun lots. I'm making a bigger move right now. So it's like I will pack everything up really solid. If I'm gonna make small moves, I don't have to pack everything up as well. But yeah, just try to stay as mobile as can when you're trying to hunt some fishies. Okay, you see me? Spot number two for the day. I'm going to sit on my snow machine, use it as a nice little seat, and jig here. I got the dead stick behind me. As I was packing up at spot one, I did have that go off, but to no avail, no fish, no fishy. It is stunningly beautiful out, as you can tell. I'm in a hoodie, no gloves, nothing. It's like, it's literally 0 degrees right now. Sun is out. Beauty. Okay, spot three. You can tell I'm jumping around a little bit. Not a crazy amount, but just enough. Staying mobile if you can sometimes is, I'd say it's not the best method. Because like obviously I've got a fish coming up right here. I've caught a lot of lake trout just camping out in an area and chumming them up and doing quite well. I got a fish on me at 48 feet. Come up as soon as my jig was dropping. So I'm gonna say it's obviously not the only method, but it's something you can kind of switch up and do sometimes as well as run and gun a little bit. Even if you only hit say 3-4 spots in a day, which is probably what I'll do. I might hit one more, or if I've got two fish on me here right away, three fish. So if I'm marking a bunch of fish, I might just camp out here for the rest of the day, you know, when it's starting to get a little bit later. It is already 2:30, that the GPS clock is 2 hours behind, I believe. But it's a beautiful day, so take advantage of it. I got the dead stick behind me. I've got fish chasing the tube right here. Come on. Active. You know, that last spot I was at, there was like no activity at all. And I get here an instant. Like instant. See, move around. If I stay at that last spot longer, I obviously probably don't catch this fish, do I? Because that fish is here. Sometimes you have to move. Sometimes. Not all the time. Like I said, I camp out a lot when I fish for lake trout, and there's nothing wrong with that at all. And that's probably what I'll end up doing tomorrow too. Sometimes the weather doesn't allow you to. This fish is a little guy. Little guy. Little guy right in the stinger. He is tiny. 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 It's one thing, you know, the spot I was at yesterday, I never caught any fish that were this small. Chikai, here you go. A little bit of bloody, so we're gonna get you down quick. Okay, there you go. Gonzo. Got him. As that spoon was falling down, the fish rose right off the bottom. You know, like, you just have to be willing to kind of switch back and forth sometimes. If you're not catching fish, come here. Okay. This one doesn't feel big, but it's probably bigger than the last fish that I just caught, that's for sure. There's my leader. I'm gonna come up the hole. There it is, here it is, here it is. There it is. H guy. Okay, okay, okay. We got you. We got you. Okay, there we go. Nice specimen. Tell the trout today seem to be like a lighter color. I wonder if they have anything to do with the type of trout that are in the area. I don't know. What I'm saying right now probably makes zero sense, obviously, but it's how my mind sometimes functions. Okay, perfect. Trout number 4 of the day. And that's on that little super leech flutter spoon, I think. Oh, hello. How are you guys? Good. We are moving to spot 4. We're gonna make a smaller move. I'm still gonna bring the sled, but where the sled is there, that was in 65 feet. And I come over here, not too far, I got 80 feet. So what I'm gonna do is go get the sled and set up here. It's recording, I think it is, yeah. I just moved holes. I just dropped down my dead stick and it's going off. So I'm gonna let it run a bit and get the camera. Like, I literally just got it down. I'm literally just getting set up and I just got this out. It's not the biggest Cisco. It doesn't mean it's big. Like, it doesn't mean it's going to be a monster trout, but it's still a big Cisco. I'm going to wait till he runs again, and then I'm going to hit him. Got him. Oh, feels good. Or feels decent anyway. I can't tell. Still got a little bit of slack. There we go. Okay, no, it doesn't feel that big now. Felt really good at first. We'll see. So I've got like a... I'll show you what I'm using for a size of a bait down here. And doesn't mean you're always gonna catch big cis or big fish on a big bait. Little fish are aggressive too. No, this isn't that big. I really thought it was at first when I first laid into it, but obviously it was going away from me and that initial hook set turned him around. But he's coming in pretty easy right now. It's not going to be a slouch. Got tools right behind all the cameras here, which is good. He took some line out though, that's for sure. Like I said, I was literally just getting everything set up. Got the dead bait down first. I haven't even dropped the tube jig down at this spot yet. And this will be, where am I stuck? Now he wants to run. Now he feels, that was crazy. The knot got stuck at the hole. Now he feels a little bit better. I'm not sure what I'm really getting into here. This is a, here he comes. I'm at my leader. Oh, he's got a little bit of heft to him. Water's moving in the hole. I might have misjudged this fish. Now it's starting to fight. It wasn't fighting that hard at first, but now it's giving it up. Maybe it was just coming with me the whole time. Like I said, when I first set the hook, I felt some weight. There it is. Oh yeah, that's a nice fish. I totally misjudged this fish. That's a nice fish. Okay, he's burping up. There we go. Yes. Oh, camera's wet now, like a 32 or 33 incher, but so full of energy. I'm gonna get the hooks out quick and get it back. But yeah, running and gunning, baby. It's proven out to be successful for me. Give her a quick dunk. Just got the hooks out. Haven't had her out long at all. But there she is. One last look before we fire her back home. Okay. Spunky. Awesome. So yeah, just got to keep moving. This is spot 4, maybe 5 already. I'm not even sure. Looks like the camera lens might be wet. My glasses are wet. Everything's wet. Headache's still there. But hey, just keep moving. Run and gun. Maybe we'll get into a great big one yet. Fingers crossed. So this is kind of what's going on in the dead bait here. I've got like a 10-inch Cisco, something like that. I probably should be using a little bit bigger one, but that's just the way it's going. I've got two trebles here that are linked together from the shank. And you can see here, I just kind of like do a little trailer there. Got to be barbless in Manitoba If I haven't said it, this video, I'm at Athapap Lake in Manitoba, which I said has got to be barbless. And I started out at Baker's Narrows there and just kind of been working my way from the lodge, just trying a bunch of different spots. Some of these spots I've never fished before, some of them I have. But anyway, back to the Cisco. So all I'm doing with the Cisco then, I've got about like say 4 inches in between there. I'm gonna hook it in the back here. I'm gonna get rid of a couple scales. Let's hook it really, really light. And then I'm gonna take this trailer hook and I'm putting it kind of in the front of the Cisco's nose somewhere like that. Most of the fish are gonna end up taking this thing head down. So you wanna get it like this. It's also why you don't want them to run too long. Now, this should be done on an iFish Pro, but I sadly forgot all my iFish Pros at home. So I'm kind of just using a milk crate here and I've been close enough to it that I can hear it when it's kind of, it's got some line peeling out. I keep my bail open and yeah. And so that's just a waiting game with that big bait. We're gonna make one more move. Got my tube jig just sitting on the bottom here, watching it like a hawk, hoping like in the last video that a fish will come by and pick it up. I definitely miss having the underwater camera. I definitely prefer to fish for lake trout with the underwater camera. I've learned that after today. You're always learning something every day when you're fishing, right? And for me, I think I'd rather camp out on a spot and watch them on the underwater camera. Even if it means catching less fish, I still just like that whole interaction with them down there, right? Like with walleye, I love the flasher. It's a little bit harder to do with the underwater camera. Plus they're a little bit more camera shy, I find. And sometimes you're also fishing them in more stained water. Whereas when this water right here is clear enough, 65 feet down, I can see it with the underwater camera. I've got to take advantage of that. So yeah, this video and the last video, I really feel like I've kind of let everybody down in the sense that I haven't got really artsy with these videos at all. No close-ups of stuff. I just feel like I was kind of all over the map today, especially like the whole run and the gun thing. Like, I don't even know what I captured. Obviously I'll figure it out once I get home and look on the video or all the footage. But the goal is, or the dream anyway, is to one day have a camera person that can literally follow me around and capture everything. And I can just get that much more in detail. Plus being able to try to stay on fish. It's really hard to manage all the camera gear, plus trying to stay on the fish or, you know, stay mobile and keep moving, whatever, however you're gonna do it. It's easy if you go set up for the day, you know, or it's easier. It's still not easy, don't get me wrong. But it's like when you're trying to get a video done in one day, and that's how I always do my videos. I never take it over into the next day or try to build like 5 days of fishing to get one video. You know, like I could go capture all of the B-roll and stuff tomorrow, you know, and get all the fun artsy shots, pull out the drone, do all that. But I want to try to get everything done in one day because now I got to go home and I've got 2 videos to edit and then get back out there. So short little rant or long rant. I'm not even sure exactly, but I do appreciate everybody continuing to watch these videos. I appreciate the patience with me as I continue to grow my knowledge in trying to run the cameras and just capture everything and bring you with me. So thank you very much. And don't forget, get outside.